from their business operations as business income, not salary. The business income is part of the total personal income, which is taxed at individual income tax rates. The president partner is also required to submit the partnership income tax returns, or Form P, on behalf of the partnership, even though the partnership itself does not pay taxes. 2. File annual return for partnership, or Form P. While a partnership does not pay tax, it still has to file an annual income tax return, or call the Form P, to show all income earned and business expenses deducted by the partnership during the year. The partnership is required to file the Form P if it has received the paper Form P or invitation to e-file, even if it has not commenced business in that year. In the year, e-filing of Form P will be available from 1 February if a partnership e-files the Form P by 29 February. The partnership allocation will be pre-filed in the respective partners. Form B or B1 is for individual tax income tax return. With this prevailing initiative, the president partner need not separately inform the respective partners of their share of the partnership income, and the individual partners can enjoy the convenience of having their tax return prevail. 6,000 partnerships with more than 12,000 partners had e-filed their business income in February last year and availed the pre-filing service to their partners. The president partner can refer to the responsibilities of the president partners for more details. For obtaining Form P, the Form P is not available for downloading from the website. If you require a copy of the Form P, you may ask Jamie or virtual assistant available 24/7 hours at this webpage or chat with us online to resolve tax matters quickly. You also can call for an individual income tax helpline. 3. Decide on the accounting period. Partnership shall decide on the accounting period when the partnership is formed or starts to operate. Most business, including partnership, choose accounting periods that end on 31st each December each year. You may choose an accounting period that ends on any dates. Example 1. Accounting period that ends on 31st December. Your partnership starts on 1 April 2016, and you choose the accounting period to end on 31st December each year. The relevant accounting periods and the respective years of assessments are: first accounting period is 1 April 2016 to 31st December 2016 for year assessment 2017. Second accounting period, 1 January 2017 to 31st December 2017 for year assessment of 2018. For the third accounting period, 1 January 2018 to 31st December 2018 for year assessment of 2019. Whereas for a fourth accounting period is from 1 January 2019 to 31st December 2019 for year assessment of 2020. Example 2, accounting period other than 31st December. Your business starts on 1 April 2016, and you choose to end your accounting period on 31st March. The relevant accounting periods and the respective year assessments are: first accounting period is 1st April 2016 to 31st March 2017 for year assessment 2018. Second accounting period is 1st April 2017 to 31st March 2018 for year assessment 2019. Third accounting period is 1st April 2018 to 31st March 2019 for year assessment 2020. 4. Prepare statement of accounts. At the end of every accounting period, you must prepare the statement accounts comprising profit and loss accounts and balance sheets. 5. Prepare a four-line statement. The president partners should prepare the four-line statements by extracting the relevant figures from the partnership statement of accounts for filing Form P. The features that you need are, first line is revenue, second line is gross profit, third line is allowable business expenses, the fourth line is adjusted profit. 6. Calculate the divisible profit. Precedent partners are required to calculate the divisible profit of the partnership and allocate the profits to the partners. Divisible profit is the adjusted profit or loss minus partners' salaries, allowances, bonuses, CPF contributions, interest on capital, and any other expenses paid on behalf of all the partners. Illustrations: calculating divisible profits. Example: adjusted profit or loss less partner salaries, partner allowance, partner bonus, partner CPF contributions, partner share of interest on capital, and expenses paid on behalf of partners. Example 3. Dividing profits among partners. ABC partnership is made up of partner A and B. Partners A and B agree that a yearly salary of $6,000 and $4,800 will be paid to them respectively at the basis of sharing of divisible profit is 60-40. For the year ended 31st December 2019, the partnership made a profit of $24,000. After deducting partner salaries, partner A and B decide to retain the profit in the partnership for the business use. The income for A and B will be as follows. Partners A, B, and total. Basis of sharing is 60 to 40, 60 for A and 40 for B in percentage. Salary for year ended 31st December 2019 for A is $6,000 and for B is $4,800. Total is $10,800. Balance divisible is $14,400 for A and $9,600 for B, which is in total will be become $24,000. Which is the partnership had made the profit for the year ended 31st December 2019. Total adjusted profit will be for A is $20,400 and for B is $14,400. The partnership income allocated to partner A is $20,400. The partnership income allocated to partner B is $14,400. The income will be assessed in their names, even though the divisible profit of $24,000 was retained in the partnership account.